ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय Today we will be reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 8, Chapter 8. Canto 8, Chapter 11, and text today will be read 6 and 7. However, the text 7, Sloka 7 is written on the board. The repetition will take place of text 7. First, I will read Text 6. Soham Durmayana Tedya Vajrena Satparvana Siro Harishe Mandatman Ghatayasva Gyativisaha. Translation. Today with my thunderbolt, which has hundreds of sharp edges, I, the same powerful person, shall sever your head from your body. Although you can produce so much jewelry, through illusion you are endowed with a poor fund of knowledge. Now try to exist on this battlefield with your relatives and friends. Will you repeat with me? Shri Bali Ruvacha Sangrame Vartamananam Kala Chodit Karmanam Kirtir Jayo Jayo Mirtuhu Sarve Syam Suri Anukramat. Sri Bali Uvacha. Bali Maharaj said, Sangrame, in the battlefield, Vartmananam, of all person present here, Kala Chodita, influenced by the course of time, Karmanam, for person engaged in fighting or any other activities, Kirtihi, reputation, Jayaha, victory, Ajayaha, defeat, Mrityuhu, death, Sarvesham, of all of them, Siyuhu, must be done, Anukramat, one after another. Translation and purport by Srila Prabhupada. Jaya Srila Prabhupada ki. Translation. Bali Maharaj replied, all those present on this battlefield are certainly under the influence of eternal time, and according to their prescribed activities, they are destined to receive fame, victory, defeat, and death, one after another. Purport. If one is victorious on the battlefield, he becomes famous. And if one is not victorious, but is defeated, he may die. Both victory and defeat are possible wherein whether on such a battlefield as this or on the battlefield of the struggle for existence. Everything takes place according to the laws of nature. Prakriti kriyamaadani gunai karmaani sarvasa. Since everyone without exception is subject to the modes of material nature, whether one is victorious or defeated, he is not independent, but is under the control of material nature. Bali Maharaj therefore was very sensible. He knew that the fighting was arranged by the eternal time and that under time's influence one must accept the result of one's own activities. Therefore, even though Indra threatened that he would now kill Bali Maharaj by releasing the thunderbolt, Bali Maharaj was not at all afraid. This is the spirit of Kshatriya. Yuddhe cha apalayanam. A Kshatriya must be tolerant in all circumstances, especially on the battlefield. Thus, Bali Maharaj asserted that he was not at all afraid of death, although he was threatened by such a great personality as the King of Heaven. So this statement for Bali Maharaj. Incident we know that churning of ocean Samudra Manthan took place, and towards the end of Manthan churning, nectar came. Nectar was produced. Dhanvantari appeared in his hand with a pot of nectar. Nectar was filled in the pot, and some struggle took place between demigods and demon about who should drink nectar, especially first. However, Lord appeared as Mohini Murti, this incarnation, and Lord managed to distribute. Of course, personally Lord administered nectar to the demigods, devas, and Lord made them to drink nectar. And then incident say that Lord disappeared there. The demons did not get any drop of, even a drop of nectar. So Lord disappeared, Mohini Murti disappeared in front of demigods and demons. Immediately again fighting took place between demigods and demons, Deva and Asura. And also here Srimad Bhagavatam described that in the fighting, the demigods got defeated. Though they have eaten, they have drunk, taken nectar, supposed to be immortal. Immortality in their sight should be there. So they have enough strength, because they were favored by Mohini Murti Krishna. They were made to drink nectar. After this incident, the fighting took place and demigods were defeated. Many demigods were killed right in the battlefield. But since they were devoted demigods, immediately they with their wholeheartedly they meditated upon the Supreme Personality of Godhead. They took shelter. Again, they took shelter at the lotus feet of Krishna. Again Vishnu appeared. And first of all, there are many demigods, they have died. By his glance, nectarian glance, beautiful glance, Lord brought them life. Again they become alive, demigod. And personally Lord also, again that beautiful took place. Vishnu also took part by the side of demigods, and many demons were killed. And again Lord disappeared. So this time many demons were killed, and also it described that the head of demons, Asuraj, Bali Maharaj was also there, and he was also killed by Indra, the thunderbolt. Bali Maharaj was killed. He lost his consciousness. And then all the demons become very much disturbed. They took the dead body of Bali Maharaj. They brought to Shukracharya. Shukracharya usana jivaya maso sanjivanya svavidya. Shukracharya has a special vidya, knowledge, learning, that is called Sanjeevani Vidya. So by influence of Sanjeevani Vidya, only one person knows that Vidya, Sanjeevani Vidya. So Shukracharya again brought back in life to Bali Maharaj. Though Bali Maharaj was finished, he was killed, he was dead, but his body was intact. So Shukracharya ji chanted a special mantra, Sanjeevani Vidya, and same time he made some preparation, some medicine, and it was administered to Bali Maharaj, and Bali Maharaj came into life. So before that, when battle was going on, so because Indra was favored by Krishna, Vishnu appeared, personally assured Vishnu victory in favor of Indra. And the sixth verse talks about Indra was threatening Bali Maharaj. Now I am here going to kill you. I will chop off your head from your trunk. Now you try to exist, you try to maintain your life. In response to that threat, here Bali Maharaj is speaking. Bali Maharaj is speaking about the very sublime transcendental knowledge. Sangrame vartmana nam kal chodit karmanam. Whosoever present are taking part in the battlefield, Sangram, they are not independent about victory and defeat. We living entity, either in battlefield or anywhere, we are controlled by the providence. Kal chodit karmanam, according to our own fruitive activities, we are completely controlled by the will of providence. And kirtir jayah ajayah mrityu sarvesyam siyu anukramat. Bali Maharaj here talked about four things: kirti, joy, victory, and ajay, defeat, and mrityu, death. Sarvesyam siyu anukramat. This happened one after another. Same person, sometime he becomes very much victorious, victory, joy, and same time, same person, in due course of time, he experienced defeat also, and sometimes very famous, when in battlefield, in fighting, one becomes victorious, he earns the reputation, in fame, and sometime that same person get even mrityu. So, kirtir, reputation, victory, defeat, and death. Shiv, anukarmat. It is not our decision that I want to become victorious and victory will come in my direction. Victory, defeat, infamy, or even mrityu, or reputation, it is completely controlled by kal-chodit karmana. According to our karma, according to our fruitive activity, this is the, everything is controlled by the will of providence, that we are controlled. So, Bali Maharaj says, yadidam kalasam. So a learned person, a learned person knows this fact, that he is not the reason. he did not, when the victory comes in his direction, doesn't become very much jubilant. And same time, defeat comes in his direction, then he doesn't lament even. So, Indra, though you are very much powerful personality, you are king of heaven, king of demigods, deva, but you will be not be glorified in the presence of learned person. In the assembly of learned person, you will be not very much, glorious. Your position is not very much glorious in the assembly of a learned person. Only fools, murkh, they can glorify you. So here we, in proper part, Srila Prabhupada talks about the nature of a kshatriya. Yudhe cha apalayan. Though Bali Maharaj was threatened, he has a great threat from the king of heaven, but still he was not disturbed at all, because he was knowing that victory, defeat, infamy, or reputation, or death, it is not controlled by Indra, it is not our decision. According to our karma, according to will of providence, it will come in our direction. In the beginning, when the demigod recognized, knew that we are in awkward position and we are very much defeated by Lord, they meditated and the Lord has appeared there. Here Sukhdev Goswami talks about that demigod were aware that Hari Smriti Sarva Vipad Vimokshanat. Hari Smriti, remembrance of Vishnu, Krishna, if one remembers, by remembrance of Krishna, one becomes completely free from all dangers. And it is a very much known fact, it is said, not even a blade of grass move without the will of Krishna, without the will of Vishnu, or without the sanction of Vishnu. Not even a blade of grass moves blade of not a whole full-fledged grass, it's some simple part of grass, even doesn't move without the will of Krishna. So Bali Maharaj was very much aware about this fact. Anything will happen, it will be due to the will of Krishna. So he was not afraid at all. He was very peaceful. And especially a Kshatriya should be very much peaceful, undisturbed, especially in the battlefield. And for a Kshatriya, like some quality of Kshatriya, saurjam, saurja, in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, nature of a Kshatriya, saurja, saurjam, dhritri, dhairja, patience, yudhe cha apalayanam, and he generally flees, doesn't run away from the battlefield. And for a Kshatriya, still, he should try his level best to protect his reputation. This is most desirable. Once in Krishna said to Arjuna, akritim chapi bhutani kathaisyanti te abhyayam sambhavitasya chakritir mara datirichyate. Akritim chapi bhutani. Krishna encouraging Arjuna, you Arjuna should fight, you should not run away from the battlefield. If you will run away, you will not do fighting, Mahabharata Yudha, then people in general will talk about your infamy. They will not appreciate that out of mercy you are not engaged in fighting. Rather, people will blame that Arjuna, though he was posing, he was thinking that great warrior, when he saw the great army, out of fear, you run away from the battlefield. So people will say, akritim chapi bhutani kathaisyanti. Your reputation is spread all over the surface of earth as a greatest archer of the time. Your reputation is spread all over the world. But now if you will not fight, then you will incur infamy opposition. And Krishna says, sambhavitasya chakritir. And for a respectable person, a honorable person in society, akriti, infamy, sambhavitasya cha akriti, marana dati richyati. It becomes worse than death. Of course, death is very much fearful, troublesome, it is very painful. But infamy, for a person who is very much respectable, he has got honor in the society, infamy is, apakirti is worse than death. Death is very painful, it gives too much distress. But for a Kshatriya, a respectful Kshatriya, akriti, opposes, infamy is worse than death. So here, though he was knowing everything, but still Bali Maharaj has to maintain his reputation. For that he was fighting. And also, though we know that Bali Maharaj, this is one of the 12 Mahajan, Swambhu, Narado, Swambhu, Kumara, Kapilo, Manu, Prahlado, Janako, Bhishmo, Balir, Vayas, Kirvayam, Bali Maharaj. One of the 12 Mahajan, great personality. But being he a Kshatriya, he was fighting and he was not afraid at all. Though he was in such an awkward position, fighting in the middle of battlefield, in front of Indra, Indra had thunderbolt, vajra in his hand, that very powerful weapon. And same time he was personally favored by, blessed by the Supreme Personality of God, Lord Vishnu. And he was threatening. There was a great threat from the Bali Maharaj, from Indra. Still he was he was not afraid at all. He was ready to fight. And we know in this battlefield, this chapter describes the Bali Maharaj was defeated, he was killed. And then all the remaining demons, Asura, they took the dead body of Bali Maharaj in presence of Shukracharya. And Shukracharya, the big doctor, better than our hodal doctor, by the absolutely dead. Only so vidya, only one person knows that vidya, that is called Sanjeevani Vidya. With this vidya, Shukracharya was able to brought back in life to Bali Maharaj. And again we know description that Bali Maharaj could not forget this insult by Indra. And also he was very much envious that Indra killed me in battlefield. This is other matter that my spiritual master, by out of mercy, he brought me back. He was very much indebted to his spiritual master Shukracharya. So again, Bali Maharaj attacked. Again he was attacked. Bali Maharaj attacked the heaven. And once again, the whole earthly planet, not earthly planet, even the heavenly planet was occupied by Bali Maharaj. Bali Maharaj again became the king of all three worlds. And then later description that how again Lord appeared as Vamandev. And Lord Vamandev took everything away from Bali Maharaj. In that regard, when that Lord Vamandev took everything from Bali Maharaj, at that time Prahlad Maharaj came there. And Prahlad Maharaj very much glorified that you, Lord Vishnu, Krishna, you had bestowed, your blessing was that Bali Maharaj become the king of all three planetary systems. And today you have snatched everything, took away everything. So your blessing, you are giving, providing all the riches and taking away all the riches. Both are very much glorious. Both are very sublime, glorious. When you provide, give, bless with all opulence a devotee, and sometimes who took away everything, that devotee becomes the poverty stricken. In both cases, your activity, your leela is very much glorious, but when you took away all the riches, all opulence from a devotee, that is considered to more glorious. So Bali Maharaj here, in this battlefield, though he was ready to fight, he fought of the last breath. He was killed by Indra in this battlefield, in this fighting. But he was brought back by Shukracharya again in life. And again he continued that enmity with demigod, and he attacked heavenly planet once again, and Indra was flatly defeated. All the demigods, they run away from heavenly planet. They vacated heavenly planet, and heavenly planet was occupied by Bali Maharaj. So here in this purport, Srila Prabhupada talks about nature of Kshatriya. Though he was very much learned personally, one of 12 Mahajan, Mahabhaga, still as a Kshatriya, he was trying his level best to protect his reputation, and Bali Maharaj did also. So here I just stop. I think if I have any question or comment. Mostly in this purport, it is described that we are not actually controller. Everything is controlled by providence. Whatever we get or what we lose, it is according to our karma and controlled by the will prakriti or will of providence, daiva sanchodita. So though it is temporary, still we should try our level best to protect, keep our reputation intact, because sambhavitasya chakriti, for a respectable person, honorable person in society, infamy, apkriti, apajas is worse than, more miserable, more painful than even death. Thabali Maharaj was here ready to fight. Okay, any condition, I am here with after last breath, I have to protect my reputation. As a kshatriya yuddhe chapalayam, I am not going to run away from the battlefield, though I know that you have thunderbolt, the most powerful weapon in your hand. Not only that, you are favored by Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu has blessed you, has taken side of you, still I am here ready to fight with you. Okay, so any question or comment here? Again, please repeat. What is point?
I see from the Bhagavatam that sometimes demons they have much deeper understanding than devatas. Same time, they are demons. Devatas are devatas. So who are more worshipable actually?
When the list of 12 Mahajan is given, the second. Two of them, out of 12, two came from the demon community. Not even a single from them. Of course, Brahma, Shiva and Brahma, they are not exactly demigod. But from heavenly planet, from the heaven, where Indra resided, king of all demigods, no one was listed. Swambhu, Narado, Sambhu, Kumara, Kapilo, Manu, Prahlad, Janako, Bhishma, Bali. Out of 12 Mahajan, two came from demoniac community of Suraj. And here, since Bali Maharaj is such a great personality, certainly in all regard, especially about knowledge, though he is a demon, but he was greater than, bigger than Indra. He says that Indra, you have become so much jubilant that now you will become victorious. But a learned person, Srila Prabhupada has quoted one, Sochyanan sochastam pragyabhadam sabhasase gatasun agatasun sanan sochanti panditah. Pandit, I mean vidwan, learned person, gat asun, agat asun, doesn't lament for one person who is dead or who is alive. Asun means life force. Dead means life force has gone away. That person called dead, death. And agat asun, alive. Asun, life force is still intact. Nanu sochanti pandita. Pandit doesn't lament for anyone. And when some favorable condition comes in our time, he doesn't become very much jubilant as well. So Indra, you reveal your jubilance because you have opportunity to drink the nectar. And it's not only drinking nectar, rather you are personally favored by Vishnu. And you are so much jubilant, now victory in going to in your side. And you are very much jubilant, but learned for Pandit, they never become jubilant for in the good condition, and they never lament even the worst condition. So you are not exhibiting, you are not exhibiting the symptoms of a Pandit, learned person. Next verse talks about yujam apandita, tatra yujam apandita. You, demigods, are not pandit, apandita. Yujam, all of you, demigods, all the demigods headed by you, Indra, you are not pandit. So, the knowledge or bhakti, it is not the monopoly of demigod. Anywhere, anybody can acquire that transcendental knowledge and achieve the highest perfectional stage. Doesn't matter whether you came from demigod community or demon community. Many times we see it. Especially Prahlad Maharaj, you saw, though he took birth in demoniac family, and Bali Maharaj, they are learned. Even Lord has, in the beginning of the, I mean, when Lord Mohini appeared, then he has appraised that you are, since you are the sons of Kashyap Rishi, you are supposed to be a learned person. You are Pandit. And a Pandit, of course, here Mohini Murthy, a Pandit doesn't put his faith in politician and so they are here Pandit. Certainly, Bali Maharaj was greater, glorious, more glorious than Indra. His position was more glorious than position of Indra, though Indra was a demigod. And Bali Maharaj was a demon. Anything else? Okay, Granthra Srimad Bhagavatam ki, Srila Prabhupada ki.